Hi guys, story recaps here. Today, I am going to explain a 1999 neo-noir horror thriller film called The Ninth Gate. Spoilers ahead, watch out and take care. A rare book collector named Andrew Telfer sits in his office, surrounded by his antiquities and books, patiently writing a letter. A leather footstool sits in the center of the office, with a noose hung over the chandelier above it. Andrew completes his letter and goes onto the footstool, the noose around his neck fastened. The chandelier catches fire as it bears the man's weight, his foot trembling beneath it until he stops moving. Dean Corso, a rare book dealer in New York City, assesses a rare book collection. He estimates that the entire collection is worth $600,000, though determining that value will take months. He persuades the collector's children to sell him a four-volume edition of Don Quixote for only $4,000, knowing that he will be able to resell it for much more. He runs into Witkin, a fellow book salesman, who accuses him of being a vulture on his way out. Corso meets with his business associate, Bernie, who knows a client who is interested in the Don Quixote collection, holding the Don Quixote book in his hands. Corso is then employed by Dr. Boris Balkan, a wealthy book collector who gives a lecture on demons and medieval literature. Corso spots a strange blonde woman in the crowd while sitting in the back row of the presentation. Balkan delves into the literary history of witchcraft, but Corso becomes bored and falls asleep. Balkan approaches the sleeping book merchant at the end of the lecture and invites him to his office, where his rare book collection is housed in a pressurized safe. The devil is a frequent theme in all of his novels. A copy of Aristide Torquia's The Nine Gates of the Kingdom of the Shadows, which was burned alive along with his creations by the Holy Inquisition, lies on a pedestal. According to history, three copies of the book survived, although Balkan claims that only one copy is genuine. Andrew Telfer sold him a copy the day before he committed suicide. Torquia is said to have modeled the Nine Gates on the Delimlanicon, a book penned by Satan himself, according to legend. The Nine Gates contain riddles that, if correctly deciphered using the Delimlanicon, can summon the devil in person. Balkan assigns Corso the responsibility of comparing his copy of the Nine Gates to the other two copies in Portugal and France in order to determine which is the genuine article. If one of the other copies is the genuine article, Balkan demands that Corso obtains it for him at any cost. Corso contacts Andrew Telfer's widowed wife, Leanna Telfer, as part of his inquiry to learn more about the book. Unaware that Andrew had sold his most valuable book, she pursues Corso for details on who bought it, which Corso denies. Andrew's unusual conduct before his death is shared by Leanna, who stares up at the chandelier from which he was hanging, despite the fact that she perceives her husband as a diehard collector, who spent a small lot on the Nine Gates in Spain. She thinks Andrew ever attempted to apply the rituals in the book. Corso walks to the library after the interview to study the pages of the Nine Gates. He notices the weird blonde woman from Balkan's lecture but is unable to communicate with her. He arrives home that evening to find his flat has been trashed, possibly by someone looking for the Nine Gates. Because of the recent incidents, Corso hands the book over to Bernie, to keep safe until his travel to Europe. Bernie swoons over the pages of the book, oblivious to the strangers lurking outside. Leanna pays Corso a visit as he prepares for his flight to purchase the book. Leanna seduces Corso when money fails to persuade him. Corso's hand strokes her legs, showing a serpent tattoo, while the two kiss passionately. Leanna searches Corso's suitcase after their night of love but does not find the book. She attacks and bites him on the chest, knocking him unconscious, enraged. Leanna is gone when Corso wakes up. Bernie doesn't answer the phone when he calls to check on the book. Corso is worried and goes to Bernie's bookstore, but he hesitates because of the dangers. Bernie is found hanging upside down from his stairwell. The Nine Gates are still safely stored in Bernie's secret compartment, according to Corso. He calls Balkan to resign the job with the Nine Gates in his suitcase, horrified by the gravity of the situation. Balkan, on the other hand, disputes the claim and instead offers Corso additional money. Corso hears an announcement in the background on the phone, implying that Balkan is at the airport. Balkan, though, hangs up before he can confirm. Corso had no choice but to take his journey to Europe. He investigates the Nine Gates and discovers an engraving depicting a guy hung upside down, similar to how he discovered Bernie. Corso pays a visit to the Sinisa brothers, two book restorers from whom Andrew purchased the Nine Gates, in Toledo, Spain. But, according to the brothers, Leanna, not Andrew, was the one who purchased the book from them. The brothers owned the book for years and had studied it enough to know it was genuine. They reveal Corso's signature in one of the engravings, implying that the book was co-written by Lucifer. A scaffolding collapses as Corso exits the brother's shop, nearly burying him in the rubble. Corso examines the remaining engravings from the book on the train to Portugal and discovers two more with Lucifer's alleged signature. He spots the blonde girl on the train and urges her to offer his best wishes to Balkan, mistaking her for a spy. The next day, he goes to Victor Farga's house, where he finds another copy of The Nine Gates. His old collection is still in his library, though Farga says it isn't as impressive as it once was. Fargus lends Corso his copy of The Nine Gates, so they can compare notes. He finds one image of a man clutching two keys in the opposite hand from the other book, while inspecting the engravings. The author's signature appears on one of the engravings, AT, while Lucifer's signature appears on the other, LCF. He notices another inconsistency, where the maze's entryway is open on one book but closed on the other. The signatures on the illustration aren't as well matched. Corso departs Fargus' house after his inspection but is nearly hit by a car. The silver-haired driver gets out of the car and appears to be approaching Corso, but he is forced to drive away by a woman on a motorbike. Corso stands there, perplexed, as the two walk away down the road. Corso spots the blonde girl in the lobby of his hotel and approaches her. Balkan's call interrupts him just as he's about to ask if she's the girl on the motorcycle. For the sake of privacy, he takes the phone in his room, where he reports the inaccuracies in the book. Balkan wants the book after hearing this, despite Corso's promise that Fargus will not sell it for any price. The blonde girl wakes him up the next day and instructs him to see Fargus again. She rides him to Fargus Manor on her motorcycle, where they discover him drowned in the fountain outside. They break into his home and discover a half-burned copy of The Nine Gates in the fireplace. They fly to Paris on the woman's request to find the third copy of The Nine Gates. The woman, however, vanishes when they arrive at the Paris airport. Corso discovers the pages signed LCF from Fargus' copy cut out at the hotel. He next pays a visit to Baroness Kessler, who claims to have seen the devil when she was 15, and is currently working on a biography about him. According to Kessler, after Torquia's death, a secret society, known as the Order of the Silver Serpents, was formed to keep the secrets from the Nine Gates and the Delamlanicon safe. Kessler used to be a member of the order, but after witnessing its decline over the decades, she decided to leave. The order used to read the Nine Gates from Kessler's copy, but after she left, a member of the order, Liana, obtained a copy from the Sinisa brothers, and used it for their meetings. Andrew would have killed himself if he learned Liana's involvement with the cult, according to Kessler's knowledge of Andrew and his marriage to Liana. Andrew may have uncovered the cult after all, given that he had hanged himself the week before. When Kessler learns of his death, he becomes suspicious and inquires about Corso's client. Kessler assumes he's been sent by Balkan even when he doesn't respond and refuses to let him see her book. Before he goes, she warns him not to get engaged any further. Corso sees the silver-haired man waiting for him when he leaves Kessler's office. To get away from him, he enters a restaurant and waits for him to leave. But the dude is still there after a few hours. Corso leaves the restaurant, exhausted, and the man has vanished. However, as he walks away, a car pursues him. He tries to flee down the river, but he is cornered. The woman floats down from the steps and assists Corso as he fights the silver-haired man. During the scuffle, Corso breaks his spectacles, and the man flees. When Corso arrives at the hotel, he asks the receptionist to check to see if Liana is staying somewhere else. Corso glances at her bright green eyes as she rubs her blood on his face as he and the woman heal from their injuries in his chamber. He is perplexed and demands answers, but is again interrupted by a phone call. He answers the phone at the reception desk and informs Balkan of Fargus' death and the missing pages. Balkan suggests seeing her again after lunch break after discovering that Kessler has sent him away. Despite the dangers the book poses, Corso makes a photocopy of the engravings before returning to his empty room. The woman has vanished. Corso hides the book beneath the mini-fridge to keep it secure. After Kessler's secretary leaves for lunch the next day, Corso enters the office. He apologizes to Kessler for not being upfront about his motives and then hands her the photocopies from Balkan's book. The concept that all three copies had flaws persuades Kessler to compare hers to Balkan's. They notice inconsistencies in three other drawings here. Kessler is intrigued by the prospect that Talkia has hidden the only true book in all three copies, allowing Corso to explore the book. He discovers a postcard sent by Balkan to Kessler among the sheets. After inspecting all of the engravings, Corso determines that there are nine versions in all of which are signed with the initials LCF. Someone knocks him out from behind while he's deep into his research. When Corso awakens, he discovers Kessler in her wheelchair, pushing herself against the wall. He turns her over and sees she has been strangled to death. Her office is on fire, and her copy of The Nine Gates is engulfed. When he returns to his hotel room, he checks behind the mini fridge and notices that Balkan's copy has vanished. According to Corso, Kessler's copy also had changes of the images, but she was assassinated and her collection was burned. Corso pauses before admitting that his book is also lost. Balkan threatens Corso's life if he does not return the book in a chilling voice. Corso locates the blonde woman after the call, who assures him that she did not steal the book. He finds where Liana is staying at the reception desk and asks the receptionist to send his note to Balkan notifying him that Liana has taken the book. Liana's hotel is unoccupied when Corso and the woman arrive. They enter the foyer and find Liana with a silver-haired man. To track them down, the woman steals a sports automobile from one of the hotel visitors. However, a big cargo truck blocks their path, causing them to lose their vehicle. They come see a sign pointing to San Martin, Liana's maiden name, while looking for the right road. They find the San Martin Chateau and enter via the trees that surround it. Several cars are stopped in front of the manor, each with a ceramic torch that casts a menacing glow on the walls. A massive feast is being prepared in the kitchen as guests dressed in black gather in front of a veiled altar. Liana is changing into a black robe with a gold pentagram necklace around her neck while Corso and the woman hike up a terrace. Corso busts open the door and retrieves Balkan's book from her suitcase. However, his triumph is short-lived when the silver-haired man takes the book from him. Corso and the woman are carried to the dungeon with a pistol to their backs. Corso tackles the silver-haired man and knocks him unconscious as they make their way down. In an unusual glee, the woman watches him thrash the man. Liana reads from Balkan's book in front of the cult upstairs. Corso blends in with the crowd, wearing the silver-haired man's cloak, waiting for an opportunity to grab the book. When the enormous doors open, an impatient Balkan mocks the cult, interrupting the ceremony. He stands at the altar, pointing out the shabby ceremony that is unworthy of the time of the Prince of Darkness. Balkan claims to be their master's only worthy pupil, having spent his life deciphering his magnificent plan. He accuses Liana of being a charlatan, prompting her to claw at his face. Balkan strangles her with her necklace after the two argue over the book. Corso tries to save Liana, but the woman intervenes, asking him to let Liana die. Balkan remains silent after performing the deed, as the rest of the cult screams and flees in terror. He picks up his book and walks back to his car, fully oblivious to the mob evacuating. After the woman reminds Corso that Balkan's public assassination shows his innocence in the murders of Kessler and Fargus, he is eventually allowed to depart. He, on the other hand, isn't pleased. He takes Liana's automobile and follows Balkan, leaving her behind, dubious of her intentions. Corso chases after Balkan's car, but it becomes trapped in the middle of a river, and he loses communication with his old client. He observes the silver-haired man's gun is still in his pocket as he exits the vehicle. While relaxing and drying his clothes in a cafe, he recalls the postcard Balkan sent to Kessler. Corso, unable to move on from the mystery, travels to the postcard's destroyed castle. As the sun sets, he walks around the castle, seeing the light in one of the turrets. Balkan's voice echoes across the engraving as he prepares to open the ninth gate. When Balkan sees Corso, he instructs him to leave and go to his New York office to collect his reward. However, witnessing how Balkan killed for the pages of the books, Corso refuses. Corso fires a gun at Balkan, but he swiftly loses the battle. Balkan enables him to see the ritual while he sinks into the splintered floorboards. Balkan douses the flooring with gas and kneels, sacrificing his soul to his master, in order to attain power equal to God. He shatters a lamp on the ground, igniting the floor in front of him. Balkan, brimming with pride, revels in the heat, feeling that it renders him invulnerable and unstoppable. Corso challenges him to demonstrate more proof of his invincibility. Balkan bathes in the fuel and lets himself burn with wild eyes, laughing maniacally. Balkan, on the other hand, panics as the flames approach his face. The ceremony was ineffective. Corso slips farther through the floor, allowing him to escape below, while he cries in anguish. Before shooting Balkan and putting him out of his pain, Corso climbs back up and grabs the stolen pages. Corso emerges from the castle, which is engulfed in flames, to find the woman waiting for him in the automobile. Her eyes sparkle against the flames as she gently touches him. The woman seduces him into an intimate evening in front of the burning castle by kissing him. The woman confesses the ninth paper was a fabrication the next day, explaining why Balkan's ceremony failed. The woman vanishes after stopping for petrol, leaving a message directing him back to the Sinisa brothers. When Corso arrives at their shop, he discovers that it is being cleared out. The brothers are no longer in the picture. A dusty paper falls from the top of the brothers' bookcase when the workmen inside remove it. Picking up the page, Corso discovers the true ninth engraving. A woman is depicted pointing to a separate castle in the engraving. As he gets closer, he notices that the woman in the engraving resembles the blonde woman he's been with. Corso returns to the castle after learning that he has been selected by the woman. The ninth gate opens for him, revealing a brilliant light that welcomes him within. Subscribe and turn on the notifications. We daily upload videos like this.